example, for the ones that don't know me, I work at the University Language Institute as an English teacher.
So we have some questions about some subjects of the best way in how to teach grammar.
Okay.
If you don't mind, it's about nine questions.
Five.
One more time, thank you very much.
No problem.
So, you can start.
The first question is a percentage question. Approximately what percentage of class time do you spend on teaching grammar for grammar activities? 10%, 20%, 30%, 40%, or 50%?
Okay. Well, I would have to say that, in general, maybe between 30 and 40%. But, that doesn't happen all the time. Like, for example, one class could be maybe 60%, based on grammar. Then another class, could be based just on vocabulary, 0% grammar, But in general, taking all those factors into account, I would say between 30 and 40%. Yeah.
Okay, the next question is related to the book, the textbook you use. Approximately what percentage of the book you use is specifically devoted to grammar activities?
Well, the book I use, what percentage? Do I have the same options or not?
Yeah, the same options.
Alright. So, let me see. It's kind of high. The percentage is kind of high. So, I would say at least 60%.
Yeah,
at least 60% is based on grammar. And I think it shouldn't be that much. It shouldn't be that much because, grammar is important, but not that important. There are other factors to consider in order to have, good communication. So grammar is not all. Say that it would depend, right? It would depend in a general English class. I would say grammar is important, of course, I wouldn't consider so important, focusing on grammar rules, right? Grammar rules. Sometimes we teachers tend to forget that our students, they don't want to know, they don't need to know about grammar rules, because we like grammar rules, but sometimes we think that our students will like it too. So I think, the most important thing would be to try to teach grammar in context, alright, like, create a situation, context, and then, from there, try to teach the structure. So when I'm talking to someone who's not my student, a friend speaking in English, I would say somewhat important.
Somewhat important.
Because, as in Spanish, in English, when we have a regular conversation, we don't focus too much on grammar, okay? So I think, it is acceptable to make some mistakes, and as long as you're aware of it, I guess, as long as you know. Because English tends to be a lazy language, right? It tends to be a lazy language. So instead of saying he doesn't, she doesn't, they say she don't, right? Just because it's easy. It's simpler, it's easier, and even though they know it.
The next question is, it's kind of related to English, but it's opposite. Because it is, what do you think when you hear a foreigner speaking Spanish using grammar correctly?
Grammar correctly?
Yeah, a foreigner speaking Spanish.
So, you know, if I hear someone speaking correct grammar, you know, I wouldn't think it's something wrong. However, you know, if the person only knows the grammar structures but doesn't communicate efficiently, then, you know, we would have a problem, you know? Okay, but, you know, if the person is using correct grammar and also communicating, you know, in a good way, you know, it's not a problem.
Well, the next question was related to what you already said. It's when foreigners speaking Spanish but using incorrect grammar structure.
Incorrect grammar structures? What do I think about that?
Yeah.
I think that as long as those mistakes don't interfere with communication, I guess it's okay. I guess it's okay, you know? And it will also depend on the context where, right? For example, if it's a Spanish teacher, no good, right?
Yeah.
With a Spanish teacher, no good.
Yeah.
So, I guess in a regular conversation, as long as those mistakes don't interfere with communication, then I wouldn't say it matters that much.
Yeah, it's acceptable.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it would.
Okay, so teacher, what would you say is the best way for teaching grammar?
The best way for teaching grammar? First of all, we have to say that there isn't one specific method that works for everybody, you know? So, my advice would be that, first of all, before you decide on your method, kind of, you know, if you have, I know it's difficult, I know it's, you know, it's only in the books, it's hard to put it into practice, but the first thing that you would need to do is try to get to know your students, okay? Their likes, dislikes, intelligences, and then take it from there, you know. And as a general rule, I would say that, you know, one of the best ways, or I think, or at least every teacher should do is try to present the structures in a context, right? In a context, right? Even if at the beginning it's just, you know, isolated sentences, you need to complete it with a context, with a specific context where the student, you know, can use it, can actually use it. So yeah, I would say, you know, get to know your student and try to use a context, some kind of context.
Okay. We also know that the best way for learning something is when it is memorable. When you have a good experience and it's easy for your mind and your personal memories. So how can the teacher present structure to make it more memorable for the student?
All right. You definitely need to use, you know, as much as you can, visual aids, right? Pictures, yeah, because it's a proven fact that you know, we memorize things better if we, you know, relate it to some visual aids. So, you know, that's something that you need to use, you know, some kind of visual aids. Context, and again, you know, depending on your students, for example, you could present a structure through a song, right? Through a song. So let's suppose most of your students like a certain song, you know, and you choose the song, and the song, of course, has that structure, you know, you can use it. You know, let's say your students like movies, you know, or series. So again, you choose a movie or a series to show it to your students. And of course, you know, all the games, all the movements that students can do, that also helps. Also helps, yeah.
You know, so finally, teacher, taking into account your own answers, or have you developed any procedure, easy and useful way to teach grammar for your students?
Well, what I have done is I have taken a little bit of everything.
Okay.
I've stolen, if you will, a little bit from you know, every method, from people that I, you know, experienced with. So, you know, what I do is I try to use visually as much as possible. And when I present common structure, I usually use a projector, okay, and then go little by little. Like for example, one word, then two words, you know, maybe one question, a negative statement, positive statement. Now, the advantage is that if something is not clear, something, you know, you notice that, you know, you're having trouble with a specific structure, you can always go back, you know, go back one slide, two slides, or whatever, and they show it. So that's the easy part, you know, of using a projector. And of course, you know, I use the board too, the traditional, the old way, the old school, the board. So I try to vary, I try to add some variety in my teaching. Because I've noticed that students, you know, it doesn't matter what method you use, they tend to get a little bit bored. Okay? It doesn't matter if you use games all the time, you know. There will be a point where they're gonna be, you know, I don't wanna play any more games, okay? So I try to add variety, you know, to what I do. And always, you know, try to present a context also. Try to present a context. So I'm always, since I like movies and music so much, I'm always looking for context, you know, lyrics and scripts of movies. And for example, the other day I was using an episode from Friends and an episode from Two and a Half Men, you know, also an episode from The Big Bang Theory. You know, every time I see something, you know, even though the rest is not related to that specific grammar point, it helps. It helps, you know. So I would say, you know, variety is the key.
The last question. How do you think your students feel about being grammar?
Most of them don't like being taught grammar. Don't like it. You know, it's like, you know, they hear grammar, they see grammar, and then they get scared. And, you know, I guess we should try to make it easier for them somehow, try to look for a way to make it easier for them. You know, one way would be not teaching the rules. Students, you know, if they are studying general English, they don't need